Hedong Yonggim Temple. Hedong Yonggim Temple is a Buddhist temple in Busan, South Korea's Gijanggan. The temple was originally called as Bomen Temple and was established in 1376 by a teacher known as Nam during the Goryeo dynasty. Hedong Yonggimse is one of South Korea's most unusual places of worship, as it is one of the country's only oceanside Buddhist temples. The temple, which has a 600-year history, is recognized for its odd location and mysterious happenings. Hedong Yonggimse was founded in 1376 on a picturesque stretch of cliffy coastline in northeastern Busan by Naung Haijin, 1322-1376, a royal counselor during the Goryeo dynasty, 918-1392, and a famous master who helped set the foundation for Buddhism in the Joseon era, 1392-1910. Nami Island. Namisim, also known as Nami Island, is a half-moon-shaped island in Chuncheon, Gangwon Province, South Korea, that was formed when the land around it was inundated by the rising water of the North Ha River as a result of the Cheongpyeong Dam's construction in 1944. Nami Island, or Namisim, is a lovely island near Seoul that is one of Korea's most famous tourist destinations. Nami Island, with its gorgeous tree lanes, woodlands, riverbank walks, and other attractions, provides picture-perfect beauty all year. It's amazing how this small island has everything. Nami Island has been the setting for many Korean dramas due to its breathtaking beauty, especially romance dramas. The hit Korean drama, Winter Sonata, in particular, has boosted the island's popularity among international visitors. On Nami Island, trees and spring flowers blossom in the spring. Beautiful cherry blossoms, which bloom from early April until mid-April, will be visible. Take a stroll through a dense stand of pine trees and redwoods when summer brings beautiful greenery to the island. Spectacular fall foliage may be seen on Nami Island from mid-September to November. Another natural beauty you will be able to appreciate throughout the fall is the reed beds along the riverbank. Nami Island is home to a plethora of great attractions and vistas. Bomyoza Temple. Bomyoza is a head temple of the Jogye order of Korean Buddhism in Cheongmyeongdong, Jeomjeonggu, Busan, South Korea. Built on the slopes of Jeom Junction, it is one of the country's best-known urban temples. Despite its proximity to Busan's hustle and bustle, Bomyoza Temple, perched on the slopes of Jeom Junction Mountain, is calm and quiet. It's a popular site for many of the city's residents, as it's surrounded by hiking trails, woodland, and stunning mountain vistas. It is also one of Korea's three great temples, with Haeinsa Temple in Gyasan National Park and Tongdoza Temple in Yangshan. It is Busan's most important temple, with a 1,300-year history and a significant place within the South Korean Buddhist tradition. Balgaksa Temple. Balgaksa Temple and Sokguram Grotto. The Sokguram Grotto, built on the slopes of Mount Toham in the 8th century, houses a massive figure of the Buddha in the Bhumisparsha Mudra, gazing out towards the sea. It is considered a masterwork of Buddhist art in the Far East because of the surrounding depictions of gods, bodhisattvas, and students, all realistically and beautifully sculpted in high and low relief. The Temple of Balgaksa, constructed in 774, and the Sokguram Grotto form a significant religious architectural complex. In 1995, Balgaksa was added to the UNESCO World Heritage List together with the Sokguram Grotto, which lies 4 kilometers to the east. The temple is considered as a masterpiece of the golden age of Buddhist art in the Silla Kingdom. Busan Gamcheon Culture Village. A picturesque attraction with a town of brightly colored houses, murals, stores, and cafes. Local government, town planners, artists, and residents engage on the cultural restoration of a neglected neighborhood, transforming it into a vibrant hamlet. Sahagu is part of the broader metropolitan region of Busan, Republic of Korea, and has a population of 375,000 people. Gangcheon Rail Park. The Gangcheon Rail Park is Korea's largest rail biking course, built on a decommissioned train route. Visitors can ride the two-quarter-seater rail bike from the famed Gangcheon Rail Park to explore the stunning hilly terrain and Bukhan River panorama, which changes with the seasons. Along the route, ride through several intriguing and enjoyable themed tunnels, disco, bubble, romance with colorful lights and noises. The Gimyujeong Rail Bike Station is where the rail bike departs for Nanggu Village. Visitors can take a stopover at the Nanggu Village halt and relax while taking in the scenery. Visitors will next board the romance train to Gangcheon Rail Bike Station, which is 2.5 kilometers away from the Nanggu Village Station. The romance train has enclosed, semi-enclosed, and open-air paths, allowing passengers to take in the wonderful scenery along the Bukhangang River. From Gangcheon Rail Bike Station, there is a free shuttle bus service about 5 minutes walk away, departing 5 to 10 minutes after getting off from the romance train to bring visitors back to departure station, Gimyujeong Rail Bike Station. Gyeongbok Palace, Seoul. Gyeongbokgung Palace, commonly known as Gyeongbokgung Palace or Gyeongbok Palace, was the Joseon Dynasty's major royal palace. It is located in northern Seoul, South Korea, and was built in 1395. Following the completion of Gyeongbokgung Palace in 1405, Changgyeokgung Palace was established as the second royal villa. It served as the primary residence of several Joseon kings and is the best preserved of the five existing royal Joseon palaces. On the grounds of this palace, established 6 centuries ago by the founder of the Joseon dynasty, are the National Museum of Korea and the National Folk Museum. Hyundai Beach, Hamdaeok Beach. Hyundai Beach is a popular tourist destination in Busan, South Korea. It is located in the namesake Hyundai district and is often referred to as one of the country's most famous and popular beaches. The beach is open all year, and there are a number of festivals hosted there throughout the year. Beach of Hamdaeok. The beach, which is only 20 kilometers from Jeju International Airport, is known for its beautiful backdrop of emerald blue waves, tall palm trees, and white sand. The beach is regarded as one of Jeju's top three. Hamdaeok Beach is located on the Pacific Ocean on the north side of Jeju Island, not far from the airport. The clearest turquoise sea, the cleanest sandy beach with white and golden sand, these are the characteristics of Hamdaeok Beach, which has earned it the nickname Hawaii of South Korea. On Hamdaeok, the beach is not crowded and tranquil, and a high hill runs the length of the beach, providing a great view of the beach and the ocean. Hwaseong Fortress. Hwaseong Fortress, also known as Suwon Hwaseong, is a fortification in South Korea that surrounds the city of Suwon, the provincial capital of Gyeongju-do. It was constructed between 1794 and 1796 by Joseon Dynasty King Jeongjo to hold and honor the remains of his father, Prince Sejo. Suwon's Hwaseong Fortress is only a 30-minute rail ride away from Seoul. This UNESCO World Heritage Site is the country's only existing walled castle and one of Korea's most important historical assets. Hwaseong Fortress is a masterpiece of 18th-century military architecture, blending East and West elements. The huge walls, four gates, bastions, artillery towers, and other monuments make up the site's total of 48 monuments. During the Japanese colonial period and the Korean War, it was partially burned down, but renovations in the 1970s restored it to its former beauty. The castle has a number of distinct towers, four gates, and the city wall that may still be seen today. The greatest thing to do is wander the city walls, you'll see everything. This tour is around 5.5 kilometers long, but due to the high rises, it will take you an hour or two to complete. Jeonju Hanok Village. Traditional Korean hanok houses, as well as calligraphy and sake museums, may be found in this cultural town. The Habakya Kingdom, 892-936, one of Korea's latter three kingdoms, had its capital in Jeonju. Jeonju was later recognized as the spiritual capital throughout Korea's most culturally defining dynasty, Joseon, because the Yi family originated from there. After many years of settlement in the area, the current Hanok village has emerged. It was previously surrounded by a city wall, similar to Naganap Seong near Suncheon, and many dwellings and villages sprang up around it. The wall was removed under the Korean Empire, and the communities began to spread. Because the Yangbang class was in charge, Hanoks in Andong and Naganap Seong were built in the Givajeep style rather than the Chogaijeep style. The current village was reportedly built so densely because Koreans were opposing the Japanese occupation of Korea after they seized the country in 1910. Today, you can see about 700 Jor Hanoks. I think part of the unique charm of Jeonju's Hanok village compared to others is how it almost feels like it's in a snow globe. Like you can see all the more modern buildings of the surrounding city, and the contrast is quite interesting. Bukchong, on the other hand, is more mixed in with the more modern city vibes. Lotte World Tower Building. The Lotte World Tower is a 123-story skyscraper in Sincheon-dong, Songpa District, Seoul, South Korea, with a height of 555.7 meters. It is now the highest skyscraper in South Korea and the fifth tallest in the world, being opened to the public on April 3, 2017. One of Korea's architectural wonders is the Lotte World Tower in Seoul. The tower represents a fusion of modern architecture and traditional Korean culture, as well as the oneness of nature and advanced technology. Lotte World Tower is equipped with everything a modern city dweller requires. This is one of the best sights to take in the amazing perspective of Seoul's brilliant lights. The Lotte World Tower also houses the new luxury Korean hotel Sinyeol Seoul. A multi-story multipurpose room in the tower has a health complex, a fitness club, and a financial center for guests. There are galleries and various shops in the tower. The 123-story tower's design is inspired by Korean pottery and calligraphy traditions, and it rises in a sleek cone-shaped form that contrasts with the city's mountain environment. The following can be found inside the tower. Observation deck. A lot of retail space. Office rooms. Luxury hotel. Apartments. Nansan Tower, Seoul. The N Seoul Tower, also known as Nansan Tower or Seoul Tower, is a communication and observation tower atop Nansan Mountain in central Seoul, South Korea. It is formerly known as the YTN Seoul Tower. The 236-meter high tower is Seoul's second tallest point. The Nansan Seoul Tower, Korea's first general radio wave tower, was constructed to promote the broadcasting and tourism industries in the future. It is a combination of a broadcast tower and an observatory that is designed in the traditional Korean style. The world's most notable towers are recognized as iconic city and country monuments. Similarly, for the past 40 years, the Nansan Seoul Tower has been a symbol of Seoul and a renowned tourist attraction. Koreans are drawn to the tower's unusual structure and the view of Seoul it provides from its tremendous height, making it the number one tourist attraction for domestic visitors. Thanks to the recent trend of the Korean wave, the tower has become a popular tourist attraction for both domestic and international travelers, with an increasing number of TV episodes and dramas filmed there. Songdo Central Park. The park is entirely man-made, having been sculpted from a desert of reclaimed ground that today forms the new city of Incheon. A waterway, it's hard to call it a lake, to be honest, flows from one end to the other and is cleaned on a regular basis by tiny barges. Renting a boat to row or paddle along the waterway is also an option. Sculptures, monuments, and historical model buildings may be found throughout the park. The Three Rice Bowls Concert Arena, which naturally resembles three enormous rice bowls, is one of the primary attractions. The park is pet-friendly, and it quickly became a favorite spot for some walking exercise after a long day at the office during my week in Incheon. Udo Island, Jeju Island, Korea. Udo lies 3.5 kilometers off the coast of Jeju, South Korea, to the northeast of Seongsongri. This is the largest of the Jeju City-affiliated islands. Udo, which means cow island in Hanja, gets its name from the fact that it resembles a cow lying down. Small island with a coral beach, eateries, and bicycle and scooter rentals that may be reached by ferry. Udo Island is a destination that is well worth your time. It's a miniature version of Jeju Island that may be explored in a few hours for quick visits or a day if you like to take your time. War Memorial, Korea. The War Memorial of Korea is a museum in Seoul, South Korea, located in Yongsan-dong. Yongsan-gu. It opened in 1994 on the location of the former army headquarters to exhibit and commemorate Korea's military history. The Korean War Memorial was built to commemorate the Korean War 1952-1953 and to signify the wish for Korea's peaceful reunification. The museum has 6 display galleries, as well as a battle experience room, a movie room, and an outdoor exhibit area with memorial statues. The Korean War and the dream for reunification are symbolized by the Statue of Brothers, which is positioned in the museum's outdoor exhibition area in the southwest corner. The statue depicts a scene where a family's oldest son, a South Korean soldier, and his younger brother, a North Korean soldier, meet on a battlefield. Their embrace expresses reconciliation, love, and forgiveness. Yunjung Hermitage. In front of Daengjeon Hall stands the 3-story stone pagoda of Yunjung Hermitage. The Buddhist monk Yusang built Yunjung Hermitage in 677, and it was previously known as Gwaneksa Temple. The temple was restored multiple times after its initial construction, and when it hosted Grand Prince Yangnyeong and Grand Prince Haoyeong, it was dubbed Yunjung Hermitage. The stone pagoda, which stands at 3.2 meters tall, has a foundation made up of 1 flagstone and 6 plates, one on each side, each carved with a single leaf lotus. A 3-tiered, square support stone supports the stereobate above the lotus carved plates. The 4 crossing flagstones that make up the single-tier stereobate are carefully placed with corner pillars on either side. 1 flagstone, a short 1-tier square rafter, is topped with a 2-tier, square support that is fashioned with a hoof-shaped support stand to hold up the main body under the cover of the stereobate.